This is Roosevelt Gist with AutoNetwork. We're here in Northern Virginia with Saab for the launch of the new 9-4X. And my guest on the show is the man, Victor Muller, CEO of Saab.
How are you? You look good.
You look great.
Well, I am actually great. I mean, how can I not be great with all these beautiful new 9-4Xs around me?
Great. Tell me a little bit about how you handled those speed bumps that people threw in the road for Saab.
Well, we actually threw those speed bumps on our own road.
Okay.
I don't think we need to blame anyone else. We knew we were going to be on a low point in liquidity, and we just weren't prepared for a lot of negative publicity that would cause a bank run of our suppliers, and we just were short of cash. We solved that now. We have an infusion of 180 million euros, so $250 million worth of fresh cash, a little bit more than that, and we're good to go.
And now you have on board a very experienced guy when it comes to product, new president, and Absolutely. You have some new product out here. Let's talk a little bit about the 9-4X here. What's that going to do for you?
Well, the 9-4X is our first foray into the crossover segment, a segment that we needed so badly at Saab and never had. And we have now. We lost so many customers over the years that were driving Saabs and then wanted a crossover, couldn't get it, and basically fell into the hands of our competitors, which you can't blame them for, right? But now we have the product, so we should be able to get them back. And this is a truly an outstanding car. To some extent, it's still a legacy of General Motors, and a very nice legacy for that matter. But of course, it's a true Saab. It's designed in Sweden by the Swedish engineers. And you can, well, you've driven it, right? You can really sense that.
Now, what are you going to do in terms of marketing and advertising? You're not a big company to get people into the product. And what's been the dealer response for this particular car?
Well, this particular car is actually first shown to you and then to the dealers. I mean, they've seen it, but they haven't driven it yet.
Okay.
But for those who have actually driven it, they're completely over the moon with it. This is the missing link in their product portfolio. So our expectations, particularly for the American market, are very high. The car as such is truly, you know, a car which fits halfway between a Q5 and a Q7. It has a nice low stance. It's a Saab in terms of its design. It was still from the days that Anthony Lowe designed the 9.5 and the 9.4X. But of course, the new product director, the design director, Jason Castriota, is going to show his first real road-going car next year when the new 9.3 comes in October. But as a teaser to show what Saab is capable of and where our design language is going, we've shown a beautiful concept car. It's the Phoenix at the Geneva Salon, and the response has been overwhelmingly positive.
Well, now you have some new product, you have a new president. What's your first goal now?
Well, my first goal is to get this company profitable. And our objective is to do that by 2012, 2011 still being a transition year. And as soon as it's profitable, we have a whole new ballgame, right?
Right.
And that is really my prime objective.
Now, I saw you hanging out the window today in the new 9-4X, waving at everybody. What it puts a big smile on Victor's face when you see this new car?
Well, I mean, you see a lot of journalists with very big smiles too, right? It's not that just I'm the only one smiling. On the contrary, no. I think this car brings the message home that Saab is alive and kicking. Right, we're bringing out a fantastic range of new products. Maybe a little bit less hot for the American market is the 9.5 Sport Combi, the station wagon, although we'll probably sell them very well in the northeast of the country. That is all new product coming since we acquired the company in February of last year. And we're very excited about it. The company will have, by October 2012, just a year and a half away, the widest and newest product portfolio in its entire 68-year history, right? Never before. And still, our projections in terms of sales are no higher than what we did in 2007 and 2008, right? When the crisis was really looming. And the company was coping with a 13-year-old 9.5. So I think that our projections are very moderate. And if we do well, which I think we will, we could easily exceed them.
Okay, back to my question. What puts the big smile on Victor's face when he gets in a 9-4X?
Well, what really puts a big smile on my face is that I see a Saab, right? This is a car which has been built with the passion of the Swedish engineers that have been on this project, some of whom are actually here. And it's a Saab. And Saabs are different, right? Saabs are not for everyone. And we don't need to sell cars to everyone. We need to sell the cars to a select group of people that want something else, right? People that are not really necessarily satisfied with driving one of the big three German super brands. And of course, they're fantastic cars. There's nothing wrong with that. But a lot of people want something else. And I think we are the true alternative to the Audis and the Mercedes and the BMWs of this world for people that are independent thinkers and have a desire to make a very understated position on what they're driving. And, right. And I think Saab really does that.
Great. Thanks, Victor, for taking the time.
Thank you, Roosevelt.
It's Roosevelt Gifts with Auto Network. We're here in Northern Virginia. We started out with Washington, D.C. with Saab for the launch of the new 9-4X. And as always, please buckle up. Don't drink and drive. See you next time.
Bye, Saab.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.